Vishnu Purana. It is a sacred text containing different incarnations of Lord Vishnu. Whenever our sacred earth was burdened with the terror of destructions and sins, Lord Vishnu would descend on this earth in the form of various incarnations to alleviate the terror. This story is about one such incarnation of Lord Vishnu, which begins at the main entrance of Lord Vishnu's abode.
Dare to stop our chariot.
I am Vijay.
And I am Jay. And we are the guardians of Lord Vishnu's main palace, do you understand? And nobody is allowed in here without permission. So go away from here.
Don't you know who we are?
There is no need for introduction. You just can't go in.
You have insulted us by not letting us in. You will have to incur the wrath of our curse. Both of you would have to take three births in the mortal world of the earth. You would turn into the biggest enemy of Lord Vishnu, whose palace you are so proudly guarding right now. And remember, in each of your three lives, you would be killed by Lord Vishnu in his different incarnations. You'll find a place in heaven only after that.
Who are you to curse us so severely?
We are the sons of Lord Vishnu.
Thus, Jay and Vijay had to take birth on this mortal earth. In their first life, they were born in a demon dynasty as brothers. They were called Hiranyakashipu and Hiranyakashipu. True to the curse, they both were Lord Vishnu's bitterest enemies. They would kill ruthlessly anyone who worshipped Lord Vishnu. They would terrorize everyone, including saints, deities, and humans. The entire mankind was petrified of them. Especially Hiranyaksh. And at long last, Lord Vishnu decided to incarnate himself in the form of a boar or Varaha Avatar in order to destroy Hiranyaksh.
Vishnu becomes so invincible that he dares to kill my brother. I will destroy Vishnu. I will wipe out all the deities. I want destruction! Destruction!
Swaha, Swaha.
Speak up! Who's the Lord of the Three Worlds?
Lord Vishnu! He's our savior!
And we are your killers! Yes, killers!
Datis? How come the datis are here?
Run! Run! Or else the datis will kill us all! Datis! Run! Run! Run!
See that? No demon is left alive! Attack! Don't spare anyone!
Destroy all spirits.
Run! Run! Run!
If this continues, we will always be defeated by the deities. Therefore, we should be more stronger than them. I have to become more powerful at any cost.
If I wish to become Lord of the Three Worlds, then I have to make myself stronger than Vishnu. I have to become invincible. There's only one way to do so. Only one way.
And in order to further empower himself, Hiranyakashipu began doing intense tapasya or penance amidst the forest on the Mandirachalam hills. Neither deterred by the daylight or the darkness, nor is he frightened of the wild animals. The day ushered in night, and the night ushered in a new day. And this is how weeks and months passed by. Strong winds or thunder, rains or lightning, nothing could distract Hiranyakashipu from his penance. He stood still, immovable, like a mountain.
Listen. Ever since Hiranyakashipu has begun his asceticism, the demons too have stopped terrorizing people on the earth.
Yes, this is our great scope and an opportunity to cripple all the evil spirits and demonic forces forever.
So that when Hiranyakashipu goes back, he would have great power, but he won't have any army to fight with.
Are coming to attack us! Run! Run!
We can't face them without our king! Run!
Deities have come!
Wait! Listen! I'll be your wife! Take us along also!
You saved your life and I will save mine! Run!
Save your life! Run!
Don't leave us! Wait!
The deities try to avenge the killing of their kind by destroying the demons and turning them into ashes. The demons were petrified of the deities. They could not withstand them, and eventually were crushed by the deities.
Huh?
Himself descended on earth along with other deities to attack Hiranyakashipu's palace. He destroyed it completely.
The queen of the demon king Kadu,
wife of Hiranyakashipu, is standing in front of me.
I beg of you, my lord, I beg of you not to kill me, because there's one more life breathing inside me. I'm going to be a mother.
No, I won't let this happen. Come on!
Taking away someone else's wife. Even demons don't do such shameful acts. Let me go. What have I and my child ever done to you that you want to destroy us? What have we done? Why do you want to kill us?
Your only fault is that you are going to give birth to Hiranyakashipu's successor. For the well-being of the deities and also mankind, I will kill this child as soon as it is born.
No, don't kill my child. You cannot be so cruel.
Narayanan, Narayanan.
Salutation.
Oh Lord Indra, what is this? It does not suit you. You are trying to take somebody's wife away, that too forcibly. Narayanan, Narayanan.
My Lord, she's Hiranyakashipu's wife, and she's going to give birth to his child. Till such time the child is born, she will be in my care.
Narayanan, Narayanan. Oh Lord Indra, can you tell me what is in your mind? Would you send them back safely after the child is born?
No, not at all. I am not going to spare Hiranyakashipu's child. I'll kill the child as soon as it is born. Thereafter, I will let her go, noble sage.
Please, please don't kill my child. Please, have mercy on me, oh my lord. Have mercy.
Narayana, Narayana. Oh Lord Indra, it is not necessary that Hiranyakashipu's child will also be like him. Then why are you trying to interfere with the law of nature? Narayana, Narayana.
Noble sage, I could not understand.
Narayana, Narayana. Oh Lord Indra, the child who is right now breathing inside this lady is no ordinary child. He is the chosen one. He will be a great devotee of Lord Vishnu. And his devotion towards Lord Vishnu will be a great source of inspiration to all mankind for all time to come. My Lord Indra, you are definitely not the one to kill such a great soul. Narayana, Narayana.
Oh sage, I have tacit faith in your prediction. I will release this lady just now. She can go wherever she wishes to go.
Narayana, Narayana.
And then, Narad Muni brought Hiranyakashipu's wife to his hermitage.
My child, your husband's palace is burnt and completely destroyed. Till such time Hiranyakashipu finishes his penance and comes to fetch you, you can stay over here. I know you will not get the comfort that you're used to. But yes, if you pray with your heart to Lord Vishnu, you will surely get peace of mind. Narayana, Narayana.
In the meanwhile, Hiranyakashipu's penance continued. He was immovable like a mountain. Ants made anthills on his body.
Narayana, Narayana. My child, whoever has taken birth on this planet, it's Lord Vishnu only who resides in his soul. Hence, it does not matter if the living being is human or plant. Narayana, Narayana. My child, every human being is made of five elements. All five elements are part of this great universe. That is why all human beings are mortal. It is very important that till their end comes and they are about to die, human beings should keep their mind and heart pure and they should pray to Lord Vishnu. Narayana, Narayana.
Narad Muni went on speaking and Queen Kayadu listened to him intently. Narad Muni's spiritual discourse not only impressed the queen but also had a deep impact on the mind of her unborn child. And thus, the wheel of time kept moving on.
Om Brahmadevaya Namah. Om Brahmadevaya Namah.
Despite Hiranyakashipu's concerted penance, Lord Brahmadev was not pleased with him. But again, Hiranyakashipu was a demon. He would not give up so easily. He was completely immersed in his meditation. The fire of his meditation was so strong that his whole body started burning. The water of rivers and oceans began boiling. The entire universe felt the heat. The earth started shaking. It appeared as though the fire would devastate the entire universe. When a devotee prays for years with such perseverance and dedication, then even God is compelled to appear before him.
Wake up, Hiranyakashipu. I am pleased with your penance. What is your wish?
My lord, bless me with such immense power that no deity, nor any human being, neither an animal, nor even a bird can kill me. Bless me that no one will be able to kill me, with or without a weapon. No one can destroy me in the morning or at night. No one can destroy me from inside nor from outside. I cannot be destroyed either on the earth or in the water or in the sky. O Lord Brahma, bless me with such a boon that I become the most powerful king of the three worlds.
Son, I am aware that you will use this boon to conquer the three worlds to become the most powerful king. But remember, behind every boon that is granted, there's a hidden counter to it. I grant you the boon you wished for. That has to.
Vishnu! Now you have to surrender yourself to my invincible power! Nobody can save you from me! Nobody! Nobody! How did this all happen?
Your Majesty, while you were in the jungle doing penance, all of a sudden the deities attacked us and completely destroyed our kingdom.
Ah! Oh, my brave soldiers! Ha! Today I proclaim in front of you all that I will not spare those deities. I will take revenge against each one of them. Go on and gather all my brave soldiers and prepare yourself for the attack on the deities! Destruction! Destruction of all the deities! Destruction of Vishnu! Destruction of the human race! Prepare yourselves!
Hiranyakashipu brought back his wife from Narad Muni's ashram to his palace. By then, it was time for his wife to deliver their first child.
Pranam, Maharaj. Maharaj, the queen has been blessed with a lovely son.
My son will be even stronger than me. I will wipe out all the deities, and my son, along with me, will rule over the three worlds. But my son, first of all, we will have to think of a nice name for you. So what will that name be?
Prahlad.
Prahlad. Yes, that's a nice name. That's a very nice name. He will rule along with me over the three worlds. My son Prahlad. It's a very nice name. Huh? Attack them! Make sure no one is left alive! Destroy all the deities! Yeah. Destroy!
Destroy all the deities!
Destroy! Yeah, destroy all the deities!
Ah! From today, I am the king of the three worlds. No one in all the three worlds is more stronger than me. From now on, people will only worship me. They will worship Hiranyakashipu. Did you hear? They will only worship me.
Fearing for their lives, all the deities bowed in front of Hiranyakashipu. In spite of their detest for him, they even started worshipping him. Hiranyakashipu got a sadistic pleasure when he was addressed as God. Little did he realize that forced adulation can last merely for a few days, but not forever.
Oh Lord, how long do we have to tolerate Hiranyakashipu's cruelties? Oh Lord, please save us from the arrogant Hiranyakashipu.
My lords, please have patience. Hiranyakashipu has crossed all possible limits. His death is approaching fast. He is alive only because of the boon given by Lord Brahma. When the time comes, I will assume a different form and kill the sinner Hiranyakashipu.
But Lord, when would that time come?
When Hiranyakashipu would try to kill his son Prahlad, that is the time I will kill him.
With time, Prahlad was growing into a fine boy. He now voiced the wisdom of Narad Muni that he had heard while he was in his mother's womb, which sounded like a gentle stream of water.
Prahlad, tell me, my son, who is the invincible lord of the three worlds?
Lord Vishnu.
No. No, my son. I am the lord of the three worlds. I, your father, Hiranyakashipu. Got it?
Oh, father, Lord Vishnu resides even within you.
Prahlad, Vishnu is the biggest enemy of demons. It's time you got to know who your actual friends and your enemies are. So from tomorrow, to get the right education, you will go to an ashram.
Hiranyakashipu sent Prahlad for his education to Mahaguru Shukracharya's sons named Shund and Armak. Hiranyakashipu had warned the two that somebody had instilled faith of Lord Vishnu in the mind of Prahlad. Now it was up to these gurus to remove that faith from Prahlad's mind and to convince him that Hiranyakashipu was the lord of the three worlds. But Lord Vishnu was deeply embedded in Prahlad's thoughts.
Son, the basic tenet of learning is that we discriminate between our friends and foes.
But Gurudev, I do not have a single enemy.
Son, deities are the biggest enemies of the demons. And their protector is Lord Vishnu.
But Gurudev, how is this possible? Lord Vishnu, who looks after the entire universe, can never be anyone's enemy.
Prahlad, who has been poisoning your ears? Who is it that's preaching you all this nonsense about Vishnu? Tell me his name.
Gurudev, it's none other than my Lord Vishnu himself. He is the one who has filled my mind with spirituality and knowledge.
All right, you won't listen. I know how to teach lessons to kids like you. Come on, tell me, Prahlad. Repeat after me, repeat. Vishnu is our greatest enemy. He's coward. Come on, say he is. Vishnu is hiding because he's scared of your father. King Hiranyakashipu is not only the king of demons, but also the lord of the three worlds. You will not worship Vishnu, but your father. Say it, Prahlad, say it.
The poor teacher continued to beat Prahlad with his cane, and he kept on rebuking him. But the most astonishing part was that Prahlad did not scream even once. The students there were shocked. And the teacher could not differentiate whether he was giving vent to his anger on a kid or on a stone.
Prahlad, tell me one thing. Didn't you feel the pain when the teacher was hitting you with the stick? Not at all.
You know, Prahlad, if the teacher caned me like that, I would have fainted over there itself.
But how come you don't feel any pain, whereas we all do? Tell me.
Oh, see, you are badly hurt.
We feel the pain when we put our thoughts into the pain itself. Believe me, when I was being caned by my Guruji, at that time my thoughts were elsewhere but not on the pain.
Then, Prahlad, where were your thoughts on?
They were on Lord Vishnu. With closed eyes, my thoughts were on Lord Vishnu. I didn't even realize when Guruji began caning me and when he stopped.
Oh, really? Does the prayer of Lord Vishnu have so much power?
His prayers have immense power.
Prahlad, have you ever seen Lord Vishnu?
Of course. You can see him everywhere. He resides in every living being.
Really? Then tell me, why can't I see him?
Like me, you can also see Lord Vishnu. Surrender yourself completely to Lord Vishnu. You fill your heart with undivided faith in Lord Vishnu. Repeat after me. Om Vishnu Devaya Namaha.
Om Vishnu Devaya Namaha.
Om Vishnu Devaya Namaha.
Om Vishnu Devaya Namaha.
Prahlad, you are instigating my disciples. What a shame! I haven't seen a son like you who keeps worshipping the biggest enemy of his father. You brat! Don't you know that this same coward Vishnu killed your own uncle Hiranyaksha by deception?
Gurudev, have you ever thought of all the people why Lord Vishnu had to kill my uncle?
Certainly. I'll tell you so that you realize how cunning Vishnu is. Listen, one day the mighty Hiranyaksha invaded the heaven.
Attack them!
Ha 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 ha! Fearing him, all the deities fled from the scene. They hid themselves wherever they could.
Listen, you deities! Where are you hiding, you cowards? Isn't there a single deity over here who has the courage to fight with me? Are you all afraid of me? Huh? Vishnu, I have recognized you. You are the one who saved the earth through Varahavatar, right? If you have the power, then come. Come and face me. Come and face me, you coward.
This is how that mean Vishnu killed your uncle by deception. Do you still want to worship that wicked Vishnu?
Gurudev, if somebody hurts me or tries to destroy me, then won't my father punish him for his sins?
Most certainly.
In that case, Gurudev, Lord Vishnu is the protector of the entire universe. Therefore, anyone who tries to hurt his devotees, he will definitely punish them. Lord Vishnu has not done any wrong by killing my uncle. He just gave him the punishment he deserved.
Prahlad, aren't you aware that you nurture most dangerous thoughts? Aren't you scared of your life?
Gurudev, should I sacrifice the right path of truth because of fear?
It's useless arguing with you. If you all start off such arguments like Prahlad, then remember, I'll give you the most severe punishment. Now, go to sleep.
The wheel of time moved on. One day, Hiranyakashipu wished to meet his son Prahlad. He called for him immediately.
My pranam to the Lord of the Three Worlds.
My son, it has been ages since I've seen you. I was actually dying to meet you.
Bless me, Father.
Prahlad, my son, I bless you and grant you a boon of a very long life. Son, let me see what you have learned from your teachers. Now tell me, what is our greatest duty in life? Tell me, son.
My father, the greatest duty of all living beings should be to devote their lives in the worship of Lord Vishnu.
Hey! Is this what you have taught my son? To worship my biggest enemy? Answer me!
Forgive me, my lord.
But the words uttered by your son Prahlad are not what I taught him. At my ashram, children speak and learn what I teach them. But Prahlad always speaks whatever he wishes to.
Despite being my son, you have hurt me badly. Oh, tell me who's teaching you all this. Tell me.
Anyone who worships Lord Vishnu is blessed with an ocean of knowledge. Oh Father, just once try praying to Lord Vishnu and then you'll see your mind will be filled with pious thoughts.
Today, once and for all, I will erase the teachings of Vishnu from your mind.
Oh Father, till my last breath, no force can remove the thoughts of Lord Vishnu from my mind.
All right. Then I shall destroy the very body which imbibes the thought of Vishnu once and for all.
My Lord, what are you doing? He is your own son, your own flesh and blood.
No, it's impossible. He cannot be my son. No. You know he's the enemy in the guise of my son. And I cannot spare my enemy at any cost. He has to sacrifice his life. He has to die. Take him away. Behead him in front of the children of other demons, so that no one hears the name of Vishnu ever again!
Mercy! Mercy! My Lord, forgive him! He's an innocent child!
Prahlad! Aren't you afraid of death?
My duty is to meditate on Lord Vishnu's thoughts.
And our duty is to obey the king, do you understand?
In that case, you should perform your duty and I shall continue to meditate.
By Vishnu, but I will not let him win over me. I'll put in all my might. Prahlad should not remain alive. If he remains alive, then none of you will remain alive. Have you heard me?
Yeah.
Let him be bitten by poisonous snakes! Wild elephants! They will trample him to death! A deadly poison from the three worlds, so that he immediately dies after consuming it. Go!
And thus Hiranyakashipu and his demon army made innumerable attempts to wipe out Prahlad. But on each occasion, Lord Vishnu's miracles saved Prahlad's life. In spite of that, Hiranyakashipu could not understand the glory of Lord Vishnu. He was blind with rage. Dejected and defeated by all his attempts, he could not fathom what to do. Suddenly, he thought of his sister Holika and immediately sent for her.
What? The poison becomes nectar on touching Prahlad's lips? There is definitely some power that is letting Prahlad stay alive. Is there no power in all the three worlds which can destroy Prahlad? There is one such power. Holika.
Ha ha ha!
Holika, I was waiting for you, my dear sister. You are the only one who can get me out of this grave situation. You are the only one who can help me.
What kind of help, Ella?
Holika, my dear sister, you have been blessed with such a unique dress which does not get destroyed with extreme heat nor catch fire when it is burned, isn't it? Now the time to use the dress has come, my dear sister.
Who do you want to protect with that dress, mother?
You don't have to protect anyone. Rather, you have to destroy my biggest enemy, the follower of Vishnu, Prahlad.
Brother, all demons are aware that you have been making attempts to kill Prahlad. But for some reason or the other, you have never succeeded. There must be some reason behind it. Brother, think about it seriously once again. After all, Prahlad is your own son.
No, Holika. Don't call him my son, Holika. Don't call him my son. He's a shame to my family, a disgrace to my name. Disgrace. And listen, Holika. I have not called you here to give me any advice. At this time, there is only one motto in my life. To destroy Prahlad. That's all.
All right, brother. I'm ready to help you in this attempt also. Tell me, brother. Tell me what you have to do.
Hiranyakashipu had already thought of a plan. This time, no strategy of Lord Vishnu was going to save Prahlad. With this thought, he had erected a huge pyre within the premises of his palace. No celestial power could penetrate the four walls of his palace. Hiranyakashipu was fully convinced that Lord Vishnu would not dare enter his palace. Holika arrived along with Prahlad. She was fully covered with a strange attire which could not catch fire. Prahlad was calm as usual and was lost in the thought of Lord Vishnu. Holika sat on the pyre with Prahlad on her lap. Hiranyakashipu then signaled to his soldier to light the pyre.
Light the pyre!
This time too, Lord Vishnu saved his devotee Prahlad's life. Holika got burnt to ashes, but nothing happened to the pious Prahlad. Since then, every year people burn this Holika and play Holi, the festival of colors.
He was son of a demon, but he had Vishnu at heart. He was born in a million, he was the one Prahlad. He was told the truth is wrong, but he could not play the part. He could not be shaken, for he was the one Prahlad. Prahlad.
hear truth in front, but the pudding of truth was his to bear. There was no one like him in the world. He was the one in a million years.
After this incident, Hiranyakashipu lost his sleep. One night, all of a sudden, he woke up.
Vishnu! You coward! Where are you hiding? Huh? If you're more powerful than I am, then come out and face me! By instigating my son against me, you are proving that you are a coward! Face me! You are no god, but a trickster and a coward, so come out and face me! I want to punish you in front of everyone! Vishnu! You coward! Come in front of me! None of your tricks can kill me now, Vishnu! Because I'm immortal! I'm immortal! Did you hear me? I'm immortal, Vishnu! Yeah. I'm immortal! I'm immortal! Prahlad, the three worlds shudder at my name. No one has the power to challenge my might. I can very easily defeat death. But tell me, from where have you got the strength that you can cheat death and can defeat it so easily? Go on, tell me, where do you get the strength?
Oh, Father, the strength that I have, I owe it solely to Lord Vishnu. It's not only within me. Even the strength within you is none other than Lord Vishnu. The source of power of all the three worlds comes from the one and only Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu exists everywhere and in everything.
If your Vishnu exists everywhere and in everything, then why don't I see him? Where is he? Why is he hiding like a coward? Why can't he come in front of me? You know, I have been looking for him for a long time. A very long time.
Oh, Father, I beg of you. If only you lift the veil of your arrogance, then you will see Lord Vishnu will surely appear in front of you.
Prahlad, the veil of arrogance is not on my eyes, but it has blinded you completely. And as you say that your Vishnu is everywhere, then he surely must be in this burning pillar also, isn't it? And if he is the savior of all the three worlds, then he will surely come to save you also. He will surely come.
He will, Father.
Fine. Okay. Let me also see that. Now go and embrace the burning pillar with open arms. If there is any truth in what you're saying, then nothing should happen to you. Nothing at all, my son. So go. And if this is not true, then this burning pillar will turn you into ashes. So go. Go, my child Prahlad, go.
Ah,
Narsimha. Narsimha. Narsimha.
He is neither a human nor an animal. Who is he?
Whoever you are, I will destroy you! Hiranyakashipu, your voices have crossed all possible limits. These are the last few moments of your life.
Ha! You can't kill me! I am immortal! I have been blessed with a boon from Lord Brahma himself! Did you hear from Lord Brahma himself?
Hiranyakashipu, do recall the boon!
Yes, I do. I know I cannot be destroyed by any human. Not even by a deity, nor any animal, not even by a bird.
Now look at me. I am neither human, nor an animal, nor I am a deity, or a bird.
I cannot be destroyed in the sky, not on earth, not even in water. I cannot be destroyed from inside, nor from outside.
Neither in the sky, nor in the water. Neither you are inside, nor you are outside, Hiranyakashipu.
I cannot be killed at night, nor during the day.
It is neither day, nor it is night yet. It is dusk now, the in-between period.
Nobody can kill me with or without a weapon!
Now listen! I won't kill you with any weapon. I will kill you with the nails of my hands. Hiranyakashipu! You can see that I have countered Lord Brahma's blessing. Now your death is... certain.
Vishnu, without disrespect to Lord Brahma's boon, took Hiranyakashipu's life and thus ended his reign of terror.
Save your life!
But still Narsimha's anger was not satiated with Hiranyakashipu's death. His rage killed several demons. Deities got scared looking at this fierce form. They could not gather enough courage to calm the fierce form of Lord Vishnu. And so, they headed for Goddess Lakshmi's abode for help.
Mother, you are the only one who can pacify the fierce form of Lord Vishnu. Because none of us has that much of courage at this moment to quieten him. If you don't pacify him right now, then he will burn the entire creation with his anger.
I cannot pacify the anger of Narsimha. It's only his devotee, Prahlad, can calm this destructive form of his, my lords.
All the deities returned to Prahlad and told him that he alone could pacify Narsimha. They requested him to calm Narsimha down with his prayers. Prahlad was grieving over his father's death, but he had to perform his duty as well. So, he stood in front of Narsimha with folded hands.
Oh Lord, you are the ocean of love and compassion. I ask for forgiveness on behalf of my father. Oh Lord, please bless the soul of my father. My Lord, during the short span of my life, I have also made mistakes. I ignored my father's commands and never deviated from worshipping you. That's the reason why he became your enemy. So in a way, I share the responsibility of my father's crime. O protector of the three worlds, please forgive me for my sins.
I should apologize. You are my great devotee. Yet, I took so long to help you. You had to tolerate your father's cruelties because of me. My dear devotee Prahlad, do forgive me.
Oh, great father, through these cruelties, I have realized the depth of devotion I have for you, and I won't let this devotion lessen ever.
Long live devotee Prahlad! Long live devotee Prahlad! Long live devotee Prahlad!
Son, I am very pleased with your devotion. Ask for whatever you want, son.
Oh Lord, I have everything. My devotion to you has given me happiness of the three worlds. And today, my eyes are blessed having seen you in person. Please shower your kindness and blessings on me forever.
Prahlad, at such a young age, you talk like a scholar. I still would want you. Ask for something.
My Lord, please absolve my father of all his crimes and cruelties. In his lifetime, he could not realize your greatness. Oh Lord, only you can give him salvation.
Prahlad, a person who has a son like you is naturally red of all his vices after his death. Son, from now on, this huge kingdom is all yours. Rule in place of your father. But one thing you should always remember, to follow duty and humanity.
As you say, Lord. Lords, all of you had to suffer the atrocities and cruelties of my father. Therefore, I ask for forgiveness from you. I beg of you, all my revered ones, to forgive my deceased father's sins and bless his soul.
So it will be, my son. Go and do the last rites of your father. May his soul rest in peace. Go and do your duty.
After performing his father's last rites, Prahlad descended the throne of his father and with his devotion inspired Lord Vishnu to assume an incarnation. Because of devotees like Prahlad, the world became free of demons and tyranny and provided salvation to evil kings like Hiranyakashipu. Despite being born in a demon's family, Prahlad is considered as the greatest devotee of Lord Vishnu. This proves that God does not discriminate between his devotees. After his coronation, Prahlad remained devoted to Lord Vishnu and ruled peacefully for many years. People in all ages salute such great devotees. After being born in a demon dynasty, Jay and Vijay in their second birth too were born as demons. They were called Ravan and Kumkara. And finally, in their third birth, Jay and Vijay were called Shishupal and Dandavarna, the two tyrannical Kshatriya kings. In every birth, Lord Vishnu annexed them through various incarnations. And so this was the story of Lord Vishnu's greatest devotee, Prahlad.
Vishnu at heart. He was born in a million. He was the one for love. He was told the truth is wrong, but he could not play the part. He could not be shaken, for he was the one for love.
Thank you.
swans. Holy got turned to ashes, but Prahlad just heard of God. His father punished him all he could, but he did not stop his mind. Narsimha came and bowed to him and made it all worthwhile.
Fire and a sword, no arrow, no wall could stop his heart from smiling. They tried their best, but they failed. He was a one in a million miles.